here with us now. Actually, I have to say Vicky on the end is from the Bangles, but you're kind of standing in for somebody who's very pregnant at the
moment.
That's
right, someone extremely pregnant.
Welcome. And apart from that, we've got Kathy, Gina, Jane, and of course, Belinda. Nice to see you all.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
I know you were in the original. Which of you was sort of in the actual original band that was formed? Is it Jane?
Yes, Belinda and I in 78. And then Gina 79, Kathy 80, and then we remain
94.
We've remained the same all these years.
How many times have you split up and then come back together again?
About 40.
Is that bad? Is it?
People still give you leaving presents when you go. Yeah.
We actually split up this morning,
but we got back together.
We had a commitment, so we had to.
We're planning on breaking up right after the show.
Sure, that's fine. We had it first. Everybody says actually you really get on, which is why you keep getting back together, because it's a lot of fun.
Because
it must be so easy to have the kind of success that you've had, and obviously that you've had, Belinda, you know, going solo, and think, well, all that was behind me, and I never go back, you know, never go back down the road. But you keep doing it because it's a giggle.
Yesterday was really particularly a really great day to be in a band. Well, it was like 13 hours and we sat in traffic.
Wagon.
And it was really fun, and then we were really happy to be all together because we just laughed and screamed, and then we screamed at each other for a while.
So
and hollered at other people.
Belinda made us listen to Doris Day.
I do?
You do. Mm.
That's a first.
Sydney and Gina are like this.
Well, she's
like this.
Yeah.
Great, okay.
It's because she's on the East Coast.
You've got a new record, which is already in the charts, and you've got a new album out in March, is that right?
Which is
called what?
Return to the Valley of the Go-Go's.
Oh, well, good. And you're doing two tour dates over here?
Right, we're playing in London at the Empire Theatre on the 23rd and 24th of this month. Mm-hmm. Next week.
Next week.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah.
So is this a permanent joining together of forces, or is this just the prelude to another split?
Yeah.
Until tomorrow morning.
Oh, no, it is. It's permanent.
Yeah.
But we're going to continue to do other things, too. Belinda will continue to be a fabulous solo artist.
Do I hear the rustle of dollars?
No, actually, we all do other music besides the Go-Go's.
Yeah.
How did you two first meet?
At
a strip joint?
Strip joint.
No, we were sitting on a curb at a party. Well, actually, we knew each other before then, but we formed the band at a party.
Punk days. We were both punks.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Still are. I mean,
blue hair. Yeah. Whatever.
Yeah. And he thought everybody he knows in a band.
So let's form a band, and we did. And we just learned as we went along, really. And it just happened to be some real talent in the band.
Is it more, Belinda, reassuring to be with the band than it is to be solo? I mean, do you find it kind of warmer, more comfortable?
It is more comfortable.
It's cozy.
It's like an old boot.
Yeah. Seriously. It's a very pressured. Yeah, old boots. Fine. It's a very pressured career. I mean, What I mean is, when you're solo, do you feel that like there's more on your shoulders? You know.
Yeah. You can, this is busy too, but you can split the responsibility five ways. And when you have camaraderie, it does make it more fun.
It doesn't seem that
important. That word is important.
It doesn't seem that important, does it? When you're in a band, it's not that important when you're solo. When you're doing other things,
there is no camaraderie when you're solo, unless you're schizophrenic.
I think we qualify for that.
That's your entourage.
We're all here.
No one usually thinks we're funny.
Except each other.
You've left your little boy at home, or is he with you?
No, he's home.
And he's only
He's three.
Three.
Yeah.
Do you miss him?
Yeah, I do a lot.
Do you speak on the phone a lot?
Yeah, I do a lot. But I usually bring him, but now he's at that age where he's a little bit tough to travel with, so we have to wait for a while.
I know, three's difficult. On planes, it's a nightmare.
Mm,
so he's out of diapers now, isn't he?
Yeah,
it gets easier. Okay.
All right, well, look, you're going to be playing for us your new single at the end of the show, which is, what number is it at in the charts now?
It's number one. Not quite, almost.
Give it a week, yeah, okay, at the end of the show. And we're going to take a quick break, after which Fred is here with the weekend weather. Brian's finishing off his three-course Sunday lunch with creme brulee, and we'll see you in 2 minutes.
Cool. It's going to be quite...
On Monday's show, as Fred just said, it's half-term, and Rich and I are having a few days off with the kids, so Alison and Steve are standing in for us. The Street's Gail Platt, Helen Worth, cooks what she really likes to eat when she's not in the caff. punished quite quick, you know. Russell Grant has got the latest news on the Astro front and keeping young and beautiful with top makeup artist Barbara Daly.
Okay, you can tell your kids that PJ and Duncan are going to be here. They're with the singer, their new single, and they'll be choosing Babe Fashion to catch a pop star's eye. But we'll leave you now with the Go-Go's and The Whole World's Lost Its Head. Have a terrific week. We'll see you Monday week.
Have a good half term.
Have a good half term
well.
if you're off, and catch you in about 9 days' time.
And we'll eat your food in about 2 weeks.
And we'll eat your food in the meantime.
We will, indeed.
Belinda and the Go-Go's.